Hello aspirants, today we are going to discuss unit 1 teaching aptitude and chapter 1 that is teaching. Now this chapter is very important because ultimately you are going to become a teacher, so that's why we will be seeing one by one that what is teaching and what are the different forms, nature, characteristics, basic requirements, objectives, types and levels. So first of all, coming to the definition of teaching. Now teaching is a dialogue, teaching is a communication, teaching is imparted to give the knowledge of unknown facts. Along with that, a teacher's motive is also this, ke along with giving the knowledge, teacher should also develop the personality of the students. So teaching is not only giving the knowledge, teaching is not only the imparting of knowledge, teaching is giving the knowledge in an effective way. That means it should, teaching activity should invite feedback also. So it should be with effective communication. So this is about teaching. Now there are different forms of teaching. If we come to the forms, so first of all we see there are three forms of the teaching, that is formal teaching, non-formal and informal. Formal teaching is the classroom teaching, where we are sitting in one class and teacher is before us and we are face to face with the teacher. Non-formal teaching is teaching through correspondence, teaching through any other means like internet, like journals, magazines, but their teacher and student, they are not facing each other, one another. Then we are having the other teaching is informal teaching. Informal teaching is that teaching which we learn from throughout, from the society, from nature, and it, this learning goes throughout our life. So teaching is having three forms that I have told you, that is formal, non-formal and informal. Formal teaching, classroom teaching, non-formal, correspondence and informal experiences which we are getting and we are learning from that. So it is a nature's teaching. After that, coming to the nature of teaching, we will see that there are different aspects of nature of teaching. First of all, teaching is, if we talk about the classroom teaching, here I may tell you one thing also, that maximum part of the syllabus of teaching aptitude is pertaining to the classroom teaching, that the formal teaching. So whatever lectures we will be discussing, they will be pertaining to classroom teaching. So here also about nature, when we are going to discuss, so that is pertaining to classroom teaching. So nature's basic nature of teaching is tripolarity. Tripolarity, three poles of teaching. What are three poles of teaching? That is teaching, then student, the teacher, then student, and the social environment. Because it is the society which determines that what we are to learn and what we are to teach. That's why without social environment, teaching is not complete. So three poles of teaching are teacher, learner, and then social environment. After that, interactivity. Now classroom teaching, success of classroom teaching is based on interactivity. That is, there should be a healthy interaction between the teacher and the student, because they are having face-to-face interaction. Teacher is giving the knowledge to the students. Students should give feedback whether we have understood it or not. And then again the teacher can solve the problem and this cycle goes on. After that, teaching is always a planned activity. Teaching is never going without planning. First of all, it is planned. Syllabus is there. Curriculum is there. Then the chapterization is there. Then teacher also plan his lecture before coming to the class. So that's why teaching is a planned process. Then teaching is having multiple phases. How many phases teaching is having? There are three phases. One is pre-active phase, another is interactive, and then another is post-active. Now pre-active phase means that whatever teacher does before coming to the class, he prepares the lecture and he also prepares possible queries which he may expect from the students. Then interactive phase, whatever time the teacher is spending in the classroom, when he is having interaction with the students, that is interactive phase. Then we are having post-active phase. In post-active phase, whatever teacher does after the classroom, that is evaluation of the student's knowledge or solving the problems of the students. Now, after that, teaching is always having a qualitative approach. That teaching never compromises with quality. So that's why teaching is having quality. Motivating stimulant. Learners only come to learn that subject in which teaching is available. So that's why teaching motivates learners to come and learn. After that, teaching is a guidance, because a teacher is a guide also. So many, besides knowledge, teacher is also telling you various other traits of the life. So he's guiding how to choose good among the good and bad. Then we are having teaching is art as well as science. Now, how teaching is art? Because a teacher who is teaching in the class, he is just like playing as an actor is playing a role on a stage. So whatever personal interest teacher is having, whatever is the mood of teaching, that is shed before entering the class. So teacher is concerned only with the teaching and making the things clear to student, irrespective of his personal considerations. Teaching is a science also, because a lot of projects, they are given when the person is getting training of teaching, and we are getting a degree of that also, like B.Ed, etc. Experimentation is done, orientation in teaching is done. So that's why teaching is also a science. Now, teaching is also diagnostic and therapeutic. What is the meaning of this? The teacher, first of all, considers or expects the general learner's characteristics. Those characteristics help teacher to plan his teaching. So that is diagnostic approach. The teacher already gets the idea that what the students want. And it is therapeutic also, because when the teaching is according to the student's taste, so definitely there will be whatever problems they are facing, those problems are solved by the end of the activity. So that's why it is therapeutic also. After that, we will see that what are the characteristics of teaching. Teaching is a matter of drying out also. It is not a matter of giving in. It is a matter of drying out also. Means, okay, it is not a unilateral process. It is a bilateral process. That whatever teacher is delivering to the students, he is also expecting the feedback from the students. If the students not give feedback, then the teacher himself extracts the feedback from them. This is the quality of a good teacher. So that's why teaching is a bilateral process. Teaching is a bilateral process. So that's why it is a sort of cycle. After that, teaching is the only process which becomes a means of learning. Without teaching, one cannot learn. After that, teaching is sympathetic and kind. Teaching is always aiming at the welfare of the student. That is knowledge-wise and personality-wise. It is a reformatory in nature. So that's why it is sympathetic and kind. Then teaching is also only choice of learning. There is no other choice that through which one can learn. It is stimulating and progressive. Teaching provides you a stimulus for learning, and it is progressive also. It is dynamic, because a lot of new methods are coming. Different methods are coming up, and those methods, they are just easing the teaching and learning process. So that's why teaching is not a static one. Teaching is a stimulating and progressive activity. After that, we will see what are the basic requirements of teaching. In basic requirement, that when a teacher comes to the class, he is to face the students. So teaching should have that much attraction that teaching motivates the students to learn. Because if there is no teaching, there will be no learning. So it is the skill of the teacher also, okay, he or she should motivate the students to learn. So that's why it is a motivation stimulant. Then we are having teaching is also requiring the basic sport material. Sport material like duster, board, or any electric equipment, teaching aids, etc. So these are the also basic requirements of teaching. Objective. Teaching is never without an objective. Teaching is always having an objective. And what is that objective? That he teacher is to, or whether he is she or he teacher is to reform the student's personality along with giving the knowledge of the unknown facts. After that, there should be proper channelization of teaching. That is the basic requirement also. Channelization of teaching means, that means that teaching should be practiced in all those fields in which teaching is possible. So that's why new courses are being added in the universities and colleges, so that whatever sector is accepting this teaching, so from those sector teaching should be started. After that, we are seeing the objectives of teaching. What are the objectives of teaching? Because the definition also explains various or is hiding certain objectives. So what are those objectives? That is, teaching facilitates learning, because without teaching we cannot learn. Then teaching is developing overall personality of the student. Then it is also motivating a learner to acquire right knowledge. After that, teaching creates awareness also. That is very important point, awareness. Then teaching requires, or teaching's objective is to maintain healthy interaction between the student and the teacher. Then teaching is its objective is to materialize universalization of education. That education should be spread all around. It should not be confined to a particular place or particular region or particular type of section of population, etc. Then teaching is also establishing itself a specialized channel of activity. That is, it is a specialized channel with which the learning is possible. Then teaching's objective is updating the learner's knowledge, that there should be updating of teacher students' knowledge. After that, we will see what are the types of teaching. Now there are some types of teaching. Team teaching is there. Team teaching is that teaching where two or three teachers, more than one teacher, is simultaneously they are teaching a class, because students are having various problems, they are having various psychologies. So they are expecting that they should learn the subject or the topic from every aspect. So there are one or two teachers or three teachers, they are simultaneously coming. One teacher may be writing on the board, another teacher may be explaining the thing, and third teacher may be observing the students, whether they are getting the lecture or not. After that, micro teaching is there. Now in micro teaching, a teacher is teaching only 5 to 10 students, a small strength of students. This type of teaching is practiced for novice teachers. Novice teachers, those teachers who have just started giving this section to this particular activity, they have started teaching. They don't have any experience in teaching. So that's why micro teaching is that teaching. And it is again, it is not the evaluation of the student's knowledge, rather the teacher's role is also evaluated. When in micro teaching a teacher is teaching, his teaching is recorded, and after that it is listened, and it is teacher is listening and students are listening and the seniors are listening, and they are just telling them what reform the person needs. So that's why novice teachers, they learn a lot from micro teaching. After that, there is a macro teaching. Macro teaching means teaching 30 to 40 students at the same time in one class and covering a big chunk of the topic. So that is micro teaching. Simulation teaching is that it is role playing. That is, if some historical character is to be taught, for example, so that character is virtually played by wearing the costumes or other things. So it is called role playing. So that is simulation, but the imitation. So that's why this is the most effective way of teaching. Now levels of teaching. At the end, levels of teaching. In levels of teaching, we have three levels: memory level, understanding level, and reflective level. In memory level, that is for kids. That is, these levels arise with age, that is just to cram the things. The teacher is teaching the class, he is overall in charge of the teacher class. Now whatever he tells, the students follow because they are for kids. Then they memorize everything. Understanding level, when the students, they attain that age where they start understanding the things. So that is understanding level, is that level. Reflective level. Reflective level is that level after understanding level. This after understanding level, this particular level comes where students not only understand the thing but give the feedback also, solve certain problems which are given by the teacher. So aspirants, this is all about for the chapter 1. I am sure you might have understood it, and this is all about our unit 1 teaching aptitude, chapter 1 teaching. Now the next lecture I will be taking in the next class. So thank you very much.